On this windy but not cold day in Landover, Maryland, we've got both sidelines covered. Chris Myers is here, but first up, Aaron Andrews on the Green Bay sideline.
Well, Joe, even though the Green Bay Packers head into the postseason with a losing streak, there's a couple of things giving them hope heading in today. One, that regular season is over. Close the book. And two, they know how to win in the postseason. All the players I spoke with said if we're going to do anything in the playoffs, it's going to be because of our quarterback, Aaron Rodgers. Green Bay coach shared with me today before they left for the field, he asked Rodgers, how are you feeling? Aaron said, I'm fine. And that coach looked at him and said, great. If we're going to get to the Super Bowl, it's going to be because of you. For more on the Redskins, let's go to Chris Myers.
Aaron, I just asked Kirk Cousins if he was nervous starting in his first postseason game. He said, yeah, but I'm always nervous. I just channel it into the game. He pointed out years ago, he heard Aaron Rodgers say, the number one trait of a successful quarterback is confidence. He didn't believe it then, but he believes it now. He's confident going against the Packers, and so is his coach. Jay Gruden, grateful for what Cousins has done, but said the primary reason we're here, the Redskins are here, is because we eliminated all the drama. Wonder if we'll see drama tonight. Let's head back upstairs to Joe Buck.
All right, thanks, Chris, and thank you to Aaron. We're confident up here because we've got Mike Pereira in the booth in case anything goes on with regard to rules. Last night, real quick, a lot of conversation about Cincinnati and Pittsburgh. Did you think the officials lost control of that game?
I did not. I think everybody's trying to pin it on the officials, but let's face it, the players and the coaches have to accept responsibility. It did get out of hand, but I think the officials did everything they could do.
The ball's on the tee. The Green Bay Packers won the toss. They receive. They will work into the wind. The wind gusting up to 30-plus miles per hour. And right on cue, the ball is knocked off the tee before Hopkins will blast it away. There's the temperature, 57. We definitely drew the long straw with regard to the two games in the NFC. Freezing in Minneapolis. And how about the way that game ended? You just feel... No matter who you're rooting for, you feel sick to your stomach for Blair Walsh and that special teams unit for the Minnesota Vikings.
Yeah, you hate to see it come down to that for the Minnesota Vikings. It's a reminder that when you have opportunities to score touchdowns and you're having to settle for field goals, invariably those things come back and haunt you in a big game.
Hopkins hits it. Janis will let it go over his head, and Green Bay will start at the 20, as you saw. Spanish language broadcast available on both Fox Deportes and by utilizing SAP on our broadcast. Here's Aaron Rodgers, and the numbers are not like you're used to seeing for Aaron Rodgers. Since he became a starter, career lows across the board his last four games. That's hard to believe. 216 pass yards a game.
A lot goes into that, of course, Joe, and the struggles that they've had, but I think because of that, it's very important for Aaron Rodgers in this offense to get off to a good start.
Coon starts at fullback with Eddie Lacy behind him. Start with a throw. Pass is caught by Jones. And Rodgers starts one for one as James Jones here on the near sideline gets 11. Brought down and defended by Bashaud Breeland. Look at the name and the face. The guy on the left side of this graphic. Yeah, Lacy, Cobb, Jones, Devontae Adams, but J.C. Treader, third different starting left tackle over the last 3 weeks.
Yeah, J.C. Treader has played some this year, but they've been at the center position. Three starts there, and he has played very little tackle during his career.
On first down, play action again. Rodgers being chased. Baker can't get to him, and Rodgers just throws it away. What a year it's been for Chris Baker. A career-high 6 sacks, and he was breathing down the neck of number 12. See what they've done, that top line. 14 sacks over the last 3 games for a Redskins team that won their last 4.
Yeah, you look at the last month of the season, they really have picked it up in terms of being able to get after the quarterback. And Joe Barry, the defensive coordinator, has done an excellent job with a lot of different parts all year long.
First run of the day, Eddie Lacy, right side, not much. It'll be third and long, a gain of 1 by Eddie Lacy, and this is a Redskins defense, 31st in the NFL. In opponents' yards per rush at just under 5 per carry, but they step up there on their first chance with Lacy.
Well, here they are facing their first third down. Of course, it's third and long, and they have struggled converting on this down. And they used to be one of the best in football last week against the Minnesota Vikings in the title game. Just 2 of 11 on third down.
third down. Rodgers tipped, incomplete, knocked away by Deshaun Goldson. And after that first down on the completion to James Jones, the drive stalls for the Green Bay Packers.
Well, this is what we've seen a lot of with Aaron Rodgers is we saw the first play of the game, drop back five steps, ball comes out on time, completion to James Jones along the sidelines, and then the next two throws, it's Aaron Rodgers having to scramble outside the pocket. That's what happened on third down, too.
Ugly punt by Maste. It takes a Green Bay bounce inside the 35, but decent starting field position for the Redskins. No score early in Maryland. Here comes Cousins.
Today's game is sponsored by Southwest. Transparency, low fares, nothing to hide.
The numbers at home for Kirk Cousins are phenomenal. Highest in NFL history with that completion percentage and a record of 6-2 at home this season. For the winners of the NFC East. Quick setup and throw. Pass is caught. And that's the outstanding tight end, Jordan Reed, who's just like a big, thick wide receiver. He can run. And here are some of the guys on offense for the Redskins. And Corey Lichtensteiger is back at center. And that should really help the ground game for the Washington Redskins.
I think so, too. He's missed the last 11 games because of injury. But when he was playing through the first 5 weeks, the rushing game was much better than we saw the second half of the season. They're hoping that he'll make an impact in that run game here today.
Handoff is to Morris. Well played up front. Burnett was up there. He was not alone. Looks like he had Daniels, who's had a very good year. Mike Daniels was in on the stop. There's Clay Matthews, and that really made Dom Capers, his defensive coordinator, happy that Clay Matthews made the Pro Bowl now as an inside linebacker.
Yeah, his sixth Pro Bowl and well-deserved. And a guy who lines up in a lot of different places. On this play, he's out on the outside, and they try to move him around enough and allow him some opportunities to make some of the big plays that we're used to seeing from him.
One of the Packers' best corners, Sam Shields, missing his fourth straight game with a concussion. On third down, passes through the hands of Jordan Reed and almost into the arms of Quentin Rollins. It's three and out for the Redskins to start their day.
Yeah, a really nice start, too, for Kirk Cousins. He completes the first pass and then facing his first third down. An excellent route by Jordan Reed, and the ball's on the money, and he hasn't dropped many this year. He's just had an outstanding season, and a big reason for that, they're really healthy for the first time.
Packers and the Cowboys, the only two teams to not allow an opening drive touchdown. That continues. Good work by this defense that's played well. Here's Hyde from inside the 10. Can't get to the 20. Going to be knocked down near the 17, and a flag comes in at the end. Gene Steratore is our referee for this one. The Redskins came away celebrating as if it's against Green Bay. Here's the call.
During the return, illegal block in the back. Return team, number 39. Half the distance to the goal. First down, Green Bay. Timeout.
It's against Goodson. Right there for the shove in the back. Packers have it for the second time. No score early in Maryland.
Today's game is sponsored by Bud Light, the official beer sponsor of Super Bowl 50.
Weather could not be any better, but it is whipping down there. Gust up to 33 miles per hour. Packers working into the wind from the 8. Sideline, Jones overthrown. When the Redskins had it, Jordan Reed was trying to get that long string that was getting longer coming off his towel. And the umpire of this officiating crew having a tough time. They don't make towels like they used to in your day.
Towels are coming apart. Jordan Reed more worried about cleaning up his towel than the route that he was trying to run.
Second and 10. Here's Lacy left side. What a frustrating year it's been for Eddie Lacy. And Mike McCarthy, who took over the play calling again, his fifth game as the play caller. The numbers have not been any better than when Tom Clements was calling the plays. And I know we're going to get into this, Troy, but man, Packer fans have to wonder what in the world is going on with this offense. It's still Aaron Rodgers. They still have guys that can catch the ball. Nobody seems like they can get open, and Rodgers is missing guys, and we've never seen that.
Yeah, well, it's a long broadcast, so we got a lot of time to talk about it. But first and foremost is the offensive line. They've been beat up, and they haven't been as solid as we've seen from them in the past.
And this play shut down because J.C. Treader, the left tackle, moved early.
False start. Offense number 73. 5-yard penalty. Still third down.
Week 16 at Arizona, Don Barclay was the left tackle. They credited him with giving up 4 sacks. 4 of the 9 picked up by the Cardinals. Then week 17, they moved second team All-Pro guard out to left tackle Josh Sitton. That didn't work against Minnesota. And now it's J.C. Treader, who played left tackle at Cornell, protecting the blind side for Aaron Rodgers here in a playoff game.
A little different game when you're out there on the edge to having to try to pass protect against these speed rushers as opposed to being inside. Josh Sitton found that out last week.
Third down and 13. And in the end zone, down goes Rodgers for a safety.
You talked about J.C. Treader out there at left tackle, and they've got Preston Smith, who just beats him one-on-one right off the edge and takes him right into the lap of Aaron Rodgers, and he's trying to then move up in the pocket. And Mike McCarthy does not like to give the tackles help, but you've got to give him help. We've seen it in previous ball games. He's making his first start out there at that position this year. Preston Smith continues to be an impact player for this Redskins defense in the last month of the year.
I mean, that rookie is red hot. He led the NFL in sacks over the final 3 weeks. He had 8 during the regular season to lead all rookies. And the second round pick out of Mississippi State just worked over J.C. Treader for the first points of this game. And Preston Smith, Ryan Kerrigan, these guys can get you off the edge.
Well, Mike McCarthy, in visiting with him about deciding to put Treader out there at left tackle, he says, I think he'll be able to handle the run game just fine, but the bull rush is where he could struggle, and that's what Preston Smith brings on him, right back into Rodgers in the pocket. Great start for the Washington Redskins.
Well, right now, the Packers have to punt this into the wind with this free kick Mastay. Right now, Rashad Ross and Jamison Crowder are back deep. The Redskins could end up with good field position after the safety. Good punt. This is Ross to the sideline. Out of bounds near the 45. A 22-yard return, and Washington will start with it right at the 45-yard line. You know, you think about this defense, and we'll get back to it, but for Washington, coordinated by Joe Barry, the key for them is to get pressure with that front seven to take the load off what is a really thin secondary. And Jay Gruden's got to be thrilled with how his defense has started this game.
Well, and you've got to be able to win up front, and that's what the Redskins have been able to do when they've been able to win these ball games, and it's hit a lot of weaknesses for them.
Play action, little rollout, and the pass is caught. Big gainer to Alex Smith. Signed in the middle of December. And the Stanford product is good for 16.
Well, I like what Sean McVay, the offensive coordinator, is doing here early in the game. We saw the quick passes on the first possession. Try to get Kirk Cousins settled in, get him off to a good start, move the pocket, get the receivers out in front of you. And Kirk Cousins, who moves well, there's a good look at Sean McVay, who's really done an outstanding job. You talk to anybody within the organization, talk to these quarterbacks, they love what he's been able to do to this offense.
What's that?
Plays quiets down on first down. Here's Morris. Had a good week last week against Dallas. One of his two 100-yard rushing days, gets five.
You know, one of the things that the Redskins have done, they lost a couple tight ends that they really like to use within their running game. And with those injuries, they've had to get creative as to how they're then going to be able to block up the end of the line. And what they've decided to do is they go with number 68 there, Tom Compton, who's a offensive lineman, but they use him really as a blocking tight end type. And he does a good job and brings a lot of size then to this offensive front.
What's that?
Second down and five. Morris again fights. We'll see where they mark him. And more chippiness after this play, after we had some of it on the previous play. And Morris is at least by that spot, and he is good enough for a first down. DeSean Jackson's been involved the last couple of plays with Casey Hayward, and those two, we've seen a lot of this around the NFL this year. We were there for that Odell Beckham Jr. Josh Norman game, and we saw the game just devolve last night in Cincinnati.
Yeah, and that's something that the officials have been told to keep under control, and we certainly saw what happened last night as well.
Cousins. Jackson's involved for the first time. And DeSean Jackson gets three. Jackson didn't have a big year statistically, 30 catches. But he was hurt week one, pulled his hamstring against Miami, came back first week of November. But he is one of the legitimate deep threats, blow the top off of defense wide receivers in the NFL.
Yeah, he can do that. And when you've got a guy that can do that with that kind of speed, it sure opens up a lot of things over the middle of the field.
Second and seven. Cousins protected. Pass caught. Reed, first down.
Well, this is their go-to guy in all situations. They line him up in a lot of different positions. You see him off the ball. They do that to keep the defense, when in man coverage, from being able to get their hands on him. So he's able to get a pretty good release. He's an outstanding route runner that creates a lot of separation for his quarterback. How about the start that Kirk Cousins is off to? Hanging in the pocket, putting the ball on the money.
Inside the red zone is Washington, number eight in the league this year, scoring touchdowns. Inside the 20. Wide open Jackson to the pylon. Touchdown.
Design play here by Sean McVay. Jordan Reed, who we saw catch the earlier ball, they run him up the seam, they clear out that side, and then they bring DeSean Jackson, and he comes on the shallow crossing route, and just nobody there then to pick him up. And a great read by Kirk Cousins, and an excellent drive by this Redskins offense.
It's a scoring play, so they give it a look, make sure Jackson got it in. They're giving it a long look. He came close. Watch this.
Previous play is going to be reviewed.
Mike Pereira is down here to our right. What do you think?
Short, Joe, because here's the issue. Since his first foot came down out of bounds, he did not touchdown with the foot in the end zone. The ball's got to get over or inside the pylon.
This may not count as a score. We'll get the call when we come back.
Today's game is sponsored by Ram Trucks. Guts, glory, Ram. And by DirecTV. If you call yourself a sports fan, you gotta get DirecTV.
Let's get the call.
After review, the runner crosses the goal line, but his foot does not land in the end zone. The ball is at the half-yard line when he touches out of bounds. It will be Washington's ball, first and goal at the half-yard line. The clock will start on my ready for play.
DeSean Jackson, usually with such a great nose and feel for the end zone, had the ball in the right arm, didn't get the foot down in the end zone, So that whole line that we always say the goal line extends around the world doesn't apply. And the ball is set up a half yard away. Morris, well played. First guy there was Ha-Ha Clinton Dix. But he was not alone. There's Guyon getting out of that pile as well. Second and goal.
Well, you got to get your pad level down the lowest. B.J. Raji down there on his knees. He's not going to be blocked. And then you've got Ha-Ha Clinton Dix and Jake Ryan there also to make the key stop.
Lost half a yard, back to the one, second and goal. Again by this Green Bay front. Guyon is there. Matthews was in on it as well. Peppers. That was tremendous penetration, a loss of one.
Well, the Troy Guyon, number 98, he's the one who gets the penetration in the backfield that forces Alfred Morris then to stutter. You see the push that he gets there along that left side of the offensive line over Spencer Long. Two great stops by this Packers defense.
12th play of this drive after the safety. Drive that started at their own 45, third and goal.
Delay of gain. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
So DeSean Jackson, Troy, was within inches of a touchdown. The hustle of Ha-Ha Clinton Dix avoided the touchdown, and now the play clock that Troy circles double zeros.
Yeah, Kirk Cousins just not paying attention, and he was really frustrated with himself after they drew the penalty. And yeah, this is going to be really demoralizing for this Redskins offense. They're not able to punch this in.
What a lift it would be for Green Bay. Third and goal. Cousins fires. It's broken up. And Clinton Dix was in there for Green Bay as Pierre Garçon was the intended target. What a job by this Packer defense.
Yeah, you're going to see Clinton Dix, number 21. He drives on it, and hard to tell there. It was, he almost had to go through the receiver in order to try to make a play on this ball. But an excellent stop there by this Green Bay defense after, like you said, Joe, with DeSean Jackson in a position that should have come away with that touchdown.
This now from 25 yards away for Hopkins. And instead of at least an 8-0 lead, it's 5-0. Here's the sack for the safety for the first 2 points by Preston Smith. But the Redskins held out of the end zone. Lead by 5 here in the first. Look at the history, the great rich history of the Washington Redskins. 5-time world champions, 3-time Super Bowl champions. Sean Jackson saying, my fault for not getting it in, as we almost had our first offensive touchdown in the first half of the entire wild card weekend. That's hard to believe.
Yeah.
And the kick return by Nile Davis in that walkover win by the Kansas City Chiefs, but we don't have one from scrimmage yet.
Yeah, and you don't think much of it when DeSean Jackson fails to score the touchdown, and okay, well, we get the ball there on the half yard line and just punch it in, and two running plays, a delay of game penalty, and Green Bay Packers got a lift on that.
Hopkins kicks it away, a chance to return it for Janice. Knocked down the mark at the 20. The Shazer Everett there to make the stop. 2016 NFL Pro Bowl is just around the corner. Hall of Famers Michael Irvin and Jerry Rice select the teams of the Pro Bowl draft on Wednesday, January 27th. And you can watch the Pro Bowl live from Aloha Stadium on Sunday, January 31st. Go to NFL.com/Pro Bowl to learn more. There's Trent Williams, the four-time Pro Bowl left tackle. Well, the Green Bay offense is back out there. Not much to celebrate yet for Aaron Rodgers. Here's Lacy. Gain of a yard and a half. For the Redskins, first safety in postseason since a divisional playoff game in 1984 against the Bears. And again, it's the rookie Preston Smith who went through J.C. Treader to get it. Rodgers skips it in to Richard Rodgers. Third down and eight.
You know, the protection really has not been that poor. We've seen Rodgers now move a little bit. Of course, he did take the sack there on the safety. But outside of that, just Rodgers dropping back. And I think he's just kind of gotten to a point, Joe, where he's not really going to hang in there for very long. He's taken a lot of hits here in recent weeks.
One for five to start the game is Rodgers, third and eight. Pass for Cobb is out of his reach. And Aaron Rodgers, the reigning NFL MVP, has missed some open receivers here in the second half of the season.
Yeah, he had a chance then with Randall Cobb, and you're going to see what Aaron Rodgers is feeling. He's got a little pressure coming back towards him, but he has a guy in Randall Cobb, and, you know, if there is a go-to guy on this team, that's the guy. They try to find ways to get him the ball, but the connection just hasn't been as consistent as it needs to be.
First punt for Mastay was 35 yards into the wind. It takes another good Mastay bounce. Tap down at the 32. This has been far too frequent a picture of Aaron Rodgers for the Packers and their fans. Redskins up five. Josh Loribas, who made 11 straight starts at center before Lichtensteiger came back for this game, is in at left guard. We'll get a report on Spencer Long from Chris Myers in a moment. Taking over at their 32 up five.
What's that?
Play action. Cousins under pressure. Peppers now. Matthews ball out and Cousins back on it. Julius Peppers can still play, and then you've got Clay Matthews there to clean it up.
And Julius Peppers, he's the one who puts the pressure off the backside, off the play action pass. They're trying to get a shot down the field, and Clay Matthews, he cleans it up. Kirk Cousins very lucky here with the ball coming out to be able to get back on his own fumble. But Julius Peppers, what a year he has had, and just continues to drink from the fountain of youth. He's been outstanding with 10 and a half sacks to lead the Packers this year.
14th year in the league, delayed handoff. Here's Pierre Thomas, good pickup there. And that was on second and 22, a gain of seven. Let's go down to Chris Myers. What's going on that offensive line?
Joe, left guard Spencer Long, the starter for the Redskins, a right ankle injury suffered in the previous series. They brought him over to the bench, removed his sock, cut back the tape. They've retaped, and they're trying to get him back in. Officially, he's listed as questionable.
Took over week four. Sean Laval was the left guard to start the year. He's on IR. Third down and 15. Cousins had arms around him as he skips it into Jordan Reed. And this Green Bay Packers defense, the numbers don't blow you away, but I would say overall they've had a good year for Dom Capers, and they've started off well.
Yeah, they've got Josh Loribas there at left guard, and that's where the pressure comes from on Kirk Cousins, but smart on his part. There was nothing down the field. Third and long. Got your wind at the back, and, you know, punt it and play field position.
Tressway hits it. Hyde will stay away. And this ball shoots down inside the 15-yard line, where the Packers will wonder if they can get some traction on offense. 60-yard punt by Way. Packers have it down 5. Jay Gruden is the second-year head coach for the Washington Redskins, born in Ohio in 1967. There's John Gruden, by the way, with his shirt off. Undrafted out of Louisville, won 6 Arena Bowls. 4 as a player, then as a coach, was on the Bucs staff under his brother John, then the offensive coordinator for the Bengals. Went to the postseason every year when he was in that capacity, and there's his overall record with the Redskins, 4-12 to 9-7, and winners of the NFC East.
Yeah, and you hear Jay Gruden, you think of his brother John Gruden, and maybe he had an easy path to get to where he is today, but it was anything but. And he spent 14 years at the professional ranks below the NFL before he got hired as offensive coordinator with the Cincinnati Bengals, and he's done a great job with this team this season.
Randall Cobb gets it on a handoff, and he had to work hard to turn that into a 2-yard gain.
Well, Randall Cobb, as we've seen here really in the last 4 weeks or so, has gotten more and more playing time in the backfield. And it goes back to what I was saying earlier. They're trying to create ways of getting him the ball, and he's not a guy who carries the ball a lot. That's just his 14th rushing attempt this year. But Mike McCarthy did say that he may get more carries in this ball game than he's had in other games. The most carries he's had in any one game is 4.
Second down and 8. Abradaris with a juggle and a drop. Wasn't much out there as Goldson was bearing down on him. Third down and 8. We've seen Eddie Lacy on the bench for this series. He is really bothered by a rib injury that he suffered last week. And it is, well, it's been an inconsistent year to say the least for Eddie Lacy.
Well, we talked about it. These are possession downs, and you need to convert, sustain these drives, and once again facing third and long.
Blitz. Packers pick it up. Pass broken up. James Jones, the intended target, and Quentin Dunbar, who is an incredible story, is out there to break it up. He was a rookie in camp as a wide receiver, wasn't going to make this team. He switched to defense, and here he is in a playoff game, making a play on James Jones.
Pretty impressive. I mean, what he's been able to do, and he's just not respecting being run by James Jones. He sits on the route, he comes underneath it, makes a play on the ball. The struggles continue.
Here's Crowder on the return, and he'll hop out of bounds near midfield. Flag is down. And we'll see if this costs the Redskins. It will. Yardage here after an 11-yard return.
During the return, holding receiving team number 10. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down, Washington.
Say it was a good stop there by that Washington defense, forcing Green Bay to punt into the wind before the end of this first quarter. Of course, the penalty's going to back them up, but the wind is a factor. And if you're Washington offensively, as we know, they like to take shots down the field. This is an opportunity for them to do it while they still have the wind at their back.
Penalty was against Kerry Williams. They called it against number 10. RG3's thinking, I can't do anything right. Can't get on the field. Inactive. He gets called for a hold. It is called the wrong number. Taken over now, up 5. At their own 36. Good run on first down by Alfred Morris. A gain of 7, knocked down by Jake Ryan.
You know, Jordan Reed, we talk about what he does as a receiver. He's not someone that they really use a lot in run blocking, but he's effective enough when he's asked to do it, and he helps collapse that right side of that defensive front and helps create a little space there for Morris.
Under a minute to go, first quarter here in Maryland.
Why did he? What's up?
Cousins keeps it in trouble and throws it incomplete for Ryan Grant. Third down and 3.
Well, we talked about it coming in as far as, you know, Kirk Cousins and how he would handle his first playoff start early in this game, and obviously wanting to come out and play well, puts a lot of pressure on himself. I think he's off to a good start. He's made some nice throws. He's had a couple drops in this ball game. The one fumble that came out, he was able to recover, but I think he's off to a really nice start. They're down and three. Passes.
What a catch by Reed. One-handed down inside the 40. One-handed grab in traffic for 21.
And I don't think he was trying to throw the ball to Jordan Reed, Joe. I mean, if you look at this, the Packers think they have a clean interception for a pick six on the outside. Casey Hayward read it beautifully. It looked like that's where the ball was going, out to DeSean Jackson, and just an outstanding job. Jordan Reed probably saves that from being a touchdown for the Packers.
The new style of catch in the NFL, a one-handed grab, and what a way for the first quarter to end. Jordan Reed back after this. From your local Fox station. Redskins in their first playoff game since the 2012 season when they were led by RG3, who was the NFC Offensive Rookie of the Year that year. Last playoff win was 2005 behind Mark Brunell, leading 5-0 after one. First down, pass caught, Garcon. First down as he made a move on Casey Hayward.
Well, Sean McVay really comes up with a nice design here. They flex out Pierre Thomas, and when they did, Demaryius Randle then was out in coverage on a running back, and they got one-on-one down the middle of the field with Jordan Reed on Jake Ryan. You really can't ask for anything better than that. But Kirk Cousins just simply didn't see it.
Hey, face, face, face! We're good. Jahan, Pacer! Wide Eddie! What's up?
Morris is knocked to the ground by B.J. Raji. And the free agent to be makes a play, a loss of four.
Yeah, those guys down there in front, they're going to be really key for this Green Bay defensive front. B.J. Raji beats Corey Lichtensteiger. He's there to make the play. And between B.J. Raji and Mike Daniels and LaTroy Guyon, they have to show up big in this game.
Lichtensteiger missing those 11 games because of a neck injury. It led to weakness in his left shoulder. Second down and 14. Pass is caught by Thompson, and a good play is made by the rookie Quentin Rollins. A gain of just four.
Well, you look at that running back situation for Washington, and Matt Jones, the rookie, who is out again today. But one of the things that Jay Gruden talked about was some of the matchups that they like with their running backs as receivers against this Green Bay Packers linebacking core. They haven't been able to do anything to take advantage of it yet. But they sure like Pierre Thomas in that role along with Chris Thompson.
Third down and 10. Protected. End zone. Touchdown, Jordan Reed.
You're going to see the safety run over the top here, and then Jordan Reed's route right up the middle. One-on-one, he sells the route as though he's going to go to the middle and not up to the post, and just an excellent job by his part getting Micah Hyde to just stop enough to where they could hit the big play down the middle of the field.
Another missed extra point. This one off the right foot of Dustin Hopkins. It stays 11-0 because of this 24-yarder to Reed on third down and 10. And then Hopkins hits the right upright. It's 11-0 for the home team in this wild card playoff.
Today's game on Fox is sponsored by Chevrolet. Find new roads. By America's Navy. And by Miller Lite, the original light beer. It's Miller time.
In honor of the great Dr. Martin Luther King, there's the drive for the Washington Redskins. 7 plays, 64 yards. Washington's been getting out to big leads. Another double-digit lead, 24-0 against Dallas, 21-0 against Buffalo, 14-0 at Chicago, 11-0 here. Janis, take a knee. Kirk Cousins went down into the end zone after that 24-yarder to Jordan Reed. And they will put that in the treasure chest. This young man who is now bursting with confidence and more shoving and pushing and fighting after a play. Welcome you inside the broadcast booth. I'm Joe Buck along with Torrey Aikman. The story for Kirk Cousins, it's fun to track, and you realize that this is a guy that was always looking over his shoulder, and now that he knows that if he makes a mistake, it's okay and he'll continue, he's free and clear to do his thing.
Yeah, and we see the way that he's been able to perform. I think in the past he's put so much pressure on himself to go out because he knew his time was limited and he had to make a great impression. And when he came into this year, they said, hey, it's your job and you're not going to lose your job if you go out and you throw 3 interceptions. And the second half of the season for him has been spectacular, and his start tonight in his first start as a playoff game has been amazing.
First time we've seen Starks. He gets it on a toss running right, and Foster is there. The former Tampa Bay Buccaneer who has taken over at one of the inside linebacker spots along with Will Compton, a loss on the play of 1, 2nd and 11. This is the first time that Aaron Rodgers has the wind at his back. So far, 14 plays, 10 yards, 1 first down. And they've not been able to advance the ball past their own 32.
Yeah, and Aaron Rodgers starting this game off with just 1 completion in 8 attempts and no running game, no timing in the passing game. It's been a bad start once again.
Here's one to the sideline for Jones. Rashad Breeland is out there. Breeland is in the category of the best corner for the Washington Redskins. Their top corner now without Chris Culliver, who's injured on IR. Flag is down as Rodgers came up to the line, snapped it in a hurry, and we'll see if he caught the Redskins with too many men on the field or if it was a false start.
Men on the defense at the snap. 5-yard penalty results in a first down.
Aaron Rodgers has become a master at this.
He does it every week. I mean, you watch, he keeps an eye on the sidelines, and as soon as the defense starts to try to make substitutions, he immediately gets to the ball and gets it snapped, and time after time he catches them and it gives him a free play. And I'm amazed that defenses continue to try to substitute with him when the Packers are not huddling up.
Give Green Bay a first down. Looking right, back to his left in the pocket, down the middle for Jones. Nice catch, James Jones. Will Blackman, the former Packer, in coverage. And that's what the Packers needed on first down, a completion of 34.
Yeah, Aaron Rodgers able to buy some time in the pocket. James Jones was not on this route. He was running a curl route. He recognized that his quarterback was in trouble. He took it down the middle, and Rodgers finds him.
Here's Adams. Pretty good game last week against the Vikings and some nice moves here out on the edge. And Devontae Adams gets 9. Back to the completion to Jones.
And James Jones there in the slot position. You see he's running a crossing route, shallow crossing route. Once he sees Rodgers looking for somebody, he takes it to the middle. And so many times those have the few big plays that they've been able to get, that's how they've happened.
Second down and one. Starks cuts up field. And we'll see what they give him as far as forward progress. They are going to give a first down. First down, Green Bay, as they trail by 11. Quick throw, Starks. Heads up field, takes it to the 20. D'Angelo Hall and Bashaud Breeland out there for Washington, a gain of 5.
Well, I know that some of the successes that the Packers have had this year have been when they've gotten into their hurry-up offense and, you know, spreading people out. It's what Aaron Rodgers likes to do, and James Starks has had a nice year catching the football, a lot of that coming off the screen game, but got good hands for a big guy.
Second and 5. Here's Cobb on the handoff. Good moves. First down. What a run by Randall Cobb as he shoved Preston Smith away and picked up 7.
Well, Randall Cobb, who's an excellent return guy, and you get the ball in his hands in some space, and there really was not much there. The Redskins saw it coming. They recognized it with the motion. But he did a lot of that on his own.
Cobb drops it. Incomplete pass, 2nd and 10. This Green Bay offense in the red zone, number 18 in the NFL this year. The Packers go right back to the line of scrimmage here, causing some confusion.
Well, he got him again, Joe.
He got him again. Gruden was trying to call timeout, didn't get it. End zone, pass is caught for the touchdown. Randall Cobb. But there are flags on the field. Gruden was trying to get a timeout, was not granted the timeout, and will bring in Mike Pereira. Did you see Jay Gruden going down the field begging for the timeout?
Yeah, I saw
there
that, but the officials.
The we have offside number 99. Penalty is declined. Also 12 men. That penalty is declined in the result of the play. Touchdown.
At the snap, Joe, they're not looking back upfield. They got to focus on the ball, so they're not going to see that. You got to call timeout earlier.
You see Aaron Rodgers, he's looking as they're trying to substitute. He sees that there's a 12th guy still on the field. He gets the ball snapped, feels that he has a free play, and catch him again. Jay Gruden trying to get the timeout, but once again trying to substitute when the Packers are in a no-huddle situation.
Officials trying to get his hat back in the end zone. That's why we just had whistles. There's Cobb. What a catch. That drive looked like the Green Bay Packers to me. You get the long one to James Jones down the middle, set him up, the handoff to Cobb, and then the completion on the free play.
Well, it was better. I think the one downside of it is it was all with Aaron Rodgers pretty much ad-libbing, which is what they've had to rely on so often.
Mason Crosby is one of 5 kickers this year who did not miss an extra point. And it's an 11-7 game. Gruden wanted the timeout, didn't get it. Aaron Rodgers 5 for 6 on the drive, and the Packers are on the board. Aerial coverage provided by Nationwide. Got 18 points in this game in the first half, almost as many as the other 3 games combined this weekend. 2 yesterday, 1 earlier today. The game won by the Seattle Seahawks on a missed 27-yarder by Blair Walsh. We know that Seattle will go to Carolina on Sunday, and the winner of this game is headed to the desert to take on the Arizona Cardinals.
Yeah, and some people may be asking about the Packers, you know, with it being 7-11, you know, if they should have gone for 2 points after the touchdown, and A lot of people look at it in different ways. I don't believe so. I think you got to wait until the game unfolds and at least get into the fourth quarter before you start making those decisions. We saw the impact of that last night. Still a lot of football left to be played this game.
Somebody's going to have to hold the ball for Mason Crosby. And it happens twice, and that person is Casey Hayward. Wind is gusting here in Landover, and Casey Hayward, that cannot be a comfortable feeling knowing that Mason Crosby's right foot is going to come flying at your hand.
I never was good at that. That's why I was never a holder. Most quarterbacks are holders at some point in their careers, but I could never hold my finger there throughout the kick.
Hayward does. And with the wind out of the back of the end zone off the foot of Crosby. Back to the touchdown on the free play. Randall Cobb and Jordy Nelson lost in August. Loved it, but his Packers on the board down four.
Today's game is sponsored by McDonald's new McPick 2 menu. Value is back.
Wildcard weekend headlines, and Alex Smith, good for Alex. Andy Reid and the Chiefs, they move on. They've now won 11 straight. The Bengals blow it. Big Ben coming back. One more piece to the puzzle with Seattle winning on the road in frigid Minneapolis. Here's Pierre Thomas, left side, signed in mid-December, gets a yard and a half. And then there's the Seahawks and the missed short field goal of 27 yards. And the Seahawks, who have been to the last two Super Bowls, winning Super Bowl 48, losing in heartbreaking fashion last year. They're moving on to a meeting with the number one seed, Carolina.
Well, congratulations to those three teams that won. I think what got lost in last night's game was just how well A.J. McCarron did coming in and bringing that team back and giving them a chance to win the ball game.
Second down and eight here for Cousins, who hangs in, finds his favorite target. The catch is corralled eventually between the knees of Jordan Reed. Third down coming up. All three road teams have won this weekend. The home team here leads by four.
Well, we'll see now whether or not this Packers defense is able to make a stop here on third down. The Redskins doing okay here in this first half on third down, but being able to force a three and out after that offense went down and came away with a touchdown would be nice.
Third down and six. Cousins, pass is complete. Garcon, first down. And you talk about a quarterback hanging in, knowing he's going to get hit, and he hit Garcon in stride for 12.
Well, you got to hit him in stride, like you said, to allow him to continue to run on the move and then pick up this first down. And he had a little bit of pressure. Cousins does. He hangs back just long enough to be able to deliver the football. And Pierre Garcon is a guy who I've liked for a number of years. In fact, in talking with Kirk Cousins, he says, I feel like I need to thank Peyton Manning for the job that he did in really developing and turning Pierre Garcon into a real pro. The guy shows up every day, does exactly what he's supposed to do, and does it the way he's asked. And he's a heck of a player.
Good protection, pass broken up. Hayward defending DeSean Jackson. And Casey Hayward was there for Green Bay, second and 10.
A nice pocket in there for Kirk Cousins once again. And you watch him, he really does an excellent job of getting the ball out on timing. But this is on DeSean Jackson. He doesn't work back to the ball once he comes out of that break. Hayward does, and that's why it's an incompletion instead of a nice game.
And the Packers still without Sam Shields. Pro Bowler a year ago, out with a concussion he suffered against Dallas. Handoff is to Thompson, who breaks loose down inside the 40. A 25-yard carry by Chris Thompson.
This offensive line, as you're going to see, the job that they do up front, and each week they just continue to get better and better. This was a young group coming into this season, and Bill Callahan, probably assistant coach of the year, and the job that he has done, what he's been able to do with the young group, mostly in pass protection, has been nothing short of phenomenal.
On first down, four-man rush, and the ball's out. A sack, a fumble, and we'll see who's got it. It's the second fumble of this game for Kirk Cousins. He fumbled 9 times during the regular season. Lost only 3 of them. Packers say they have it, and they do. First fumble Cousins got on top of. This time it's Mike Neal.
Yeah, Mike Neal just does not feel the pressure. Or excuse me, Kirk Cousins doesn't feel the pressure from Mike Neal on his front side. And he had room to step up. Morgan Moses is the right tackle who's trying to block him. But Neal gets to Kirk Cousins. And the Redskins get the turnover. Packers force the takeaway. And it's something the Redskins have done a good job of throughout this season, is protecting the football. But a big turnaround here, giving the ball back to the Packers offense.
Mike Neal had 4 sacks during the regular season. This is a big one. Second fumble for Cousins, first loss of the game. And back to the field is Aaron Rodgers. Big play by Mike Neal.
Yeah, I mean, the Redskins offensively were really driving. They had momentum behind them, and they were making some plays and getting things going. And Cousins just not protecting the football in the pocket. Gives the ball back to the Packers with outstanding field position.
Play clock was at 1. Timeout Green Bay.
See Mike Neal one-on-one. He just works around the edge, and as I said, Kirk Cousins just not feeling it, not able to step up and avoid it. A little loose with the ball, and Packers ball.
And right around Morgan Moses. He's made all 17 starts this season for Washington. Next Sunday night, after the NFL playoffs wrap up, the UFC Bantamweight Championship is live on FS1. Champion TJ Dillashaw, former champ Dominic Cruz. The biggest UFC fight ever on free TV next Sunday night, only on FS1.
You know, a lot of times, Joe, on a change of possession like this, and when the offense gets the ball at midfield, which is essentially where they're at, a lot of times the play caller then will want to take advantage of that shift in momentum and take a shot down the field. And we'll see what Mike McCarthy elects to do here.
Lacy back in there for Green Bay. Rodgers has to step up and now sprint out to his right. Throw it away. Ryan Kerrigan was there for the Washington Redskins, 2nd and 10.
We saw earlier on the big play to James Jones on the scramble drill where he got down the middle, but most of the time that's hard on a quarterback when you're scrambling out. You just can't get enough on the ball. You need guys working back to you like you would in basketball. And too many times when Rodgers is on the move, receivers are not creating any separation from the defenders.
Here's Cobb. Well-designed play, and Cobb's got a first down. And blocking out in front of him, and Randall Cobb gets 12.
That was really well-designed. They get it to him, and he just takes off with it and went and got the first down. It's great job by Randall Cobb, knowing exactly where he had to get to pick up the first.
Again, the Packers hurry it up. Blitz. Pass caught. James Jones. And Jones is going to get 9. Brought down by Quentin Dunbar. Back to the line they go.
You feel a little momentum right now with Green Bay offensively.
Lacy right side. Eddie Lacy's got a first down. It's important to note that when the Packers hurry up like this, they're not substituting. And so they can get up to the line, snap it. The defense is on their own with regard to trying to get subs in there. You see the numbers with and against the wind. It is definitely a factor. Right now, Aaron Rodgers is with the wind. And we had a little attention out there for Will Compton, who was taken over for Keenan Robinson at one of the inside linebacker spots. He's the quarterback of this defense and has kind of come out of nowhere, a college free agent out of Nebraska in his second year.
Yeah, he's coming off the field, and he had his opportunity and just took advantage of that inside linebacker position, and now they're replacing him with Keenan Robinson, who started the first eight games of the season. But Joe Barry once again having to go to the bench, and something he's had to do a lot of throughout this year.
Packers with seven first downs this quarter. Only had one in the first. There's Joe Barry, first-year defensive coordinator. Son-in-law of Rod Marinelli. He's done a nice job. A bit short-handed because of injuries. Crowd's back in it. Play action from Rodgers. To the end zone for Cobb, and he is overthrown by plenty. Cobb was behind the defense, and Aaron Rodgers put too much air under it.
Well, they motion Randall Cobb across the formation, and then Breland goes with him, and so you know he's in man coverage, and you're going to get the look that you want. And you know, we just aren't used to seeing Aaron Rodgers miss those kinds of throws, and you can tell that, you know, he can't believe it either. But there's been a lot of things happening around him, but he has missed some throws when he's had opportunities that typically he just doesn't miss.
Protected him rather well here today. That's a turnaround from the last couple of weeks. Second and 10, play clock at one. Flag is down. Pass caught by Lacey, and he is swarmed. Mason Foster was in there, not alone, no gain. The flag is down. Looks like it's against Washington.
Offside. Defense, number 91. 5-yard penalty. Replay, second down.
It's against Ryan Kerrigan.
He thought he might have gotten back, but he was still in the neutral zone, so they get him. That makes this now a pretty manageable second down and five.
Ball at the 27 for the team down four. Starks able to hang on to the football. First guy there was Kerrigan. A gain of three and a short third and two coming up.
Yeah, that offsides penalty then on Kerrigan certainly helps. You run the football, and the Packers have not run the ball well, you know, here in this game. Haven't been able to really get anything going. I know Josh Sitton came out and said for them to win the game, he really felt that between James Starks and Eddie Lacy, they were going to have to combine for 30 plus carries. They haven't had much success with it when they've tried it.
Is dropped. James Jones was there, as was Quentin Dunbar. Couldn't tell if Jones had a clean shot at that pass. We will hear.
Well, this was a ball that got inside on Rodgers. James Jones, he got a hand on it. Dunbar does, but James Jones expecting the ball really out towards the sideline. The ball's inside, and Dunbar right on top of it. They're going to have to take some shots down the field on them. They're really sitting on some routes there on that outside.
43-yard try here by Crosby. He is good. He's had a good year. Third down troubles continue for the Pack. They are 0-for-5 on third down. But the lead is now 1 for Washington. Kirk Cousins famous for saying this. And it's spread around.
You like that? I like that.
You gotta like that, right?
And they love him now here with a Washington franchise, a free agent to be. He's gonna cash in here at some point. That reaction was when the Redskins were down 24 points, 24 to nothing after a 2-4 start. They came roaring back to win it. And his emotional reaction after that game, and he has really taken off, especially here in this second half. The Walter Payton NFL Man of the Year Award presented by Nationwide has a long history of honoring players. The three finalists will be announced during the AFC Championship game on January 24th, with the winner being announced at the NFL Honors Award Show on February 6th on CBS. This year's nominee for the Packers, Sam Barrington, lost to a foot injury week one in Chicago, but he's been doing good work in the community. And for the Redskins, the man pictured there, Ryan Kerrigan. First down from the 20 for the Redskins, up one.
Why didn't he? What's up?
Handed off to Morris. Morris on first down picks up three.
Yeah, that's kind of where it all began this season, really, for the Washington Redskins. Was after that comeback, they wound up going 7-3 over the next 10 games and won the last four, and you know, really became solidified as a team and gained more and more confidence as this season has gone along. And as we talked about earlier, Kirk Cousins has obviously been a huge part of that. You talk about, you know, the you like that. I was down on the field before the game, and you know, fans that got here early, they were chanting it. It's all you heard throughout pregame warm-up. So it has really taken hold, and they even printed up towels here in the stadium that have that printed on them, and they're waving them throughout this ball game.
Interesting that Green Bay takes a timeout here. Remember, Washington's working into the wind, so they want to try to get it back here with enough time on the clock to change the scoreboard before the half. 2:43 left, one timeout left for Green Bay. Second and seven. Pass is caught by Crowder. Brought down immediately by linebacker Joe Thomas. Again, a 4, 3rd and 3 coming up. And timeout taken again.
Well, we showed the numbers, Joe, in terms of what the passing numbers for Aaron Rodgers have looked like going into the wind. Not very good. Wind at his back, obviously a lot better, and it affects field position. That's been noticed in this first half also. So for the wind, as we came into the game talking about potentially being a factor, certainly proved itself out in terms of the strategy for both of these coaches.
Mentioned that 7-3 run down the stretch for Kirk Cousins. During that stretch, he's thrown 23 touchdowns compared to 3 interceptions. Interceptions were his undoing earlier in his career. Third down and 2. Matthews coming off the edge. Pass is incomplete. What a hit. Crowder was the target, had it, and Quentin Rollins was there for the Green Bay Packers. He gets up limping, but the timeouts pay off. It's 3 and out.
Well, when you're throwing this outside breaking route, especially when it's short down and distance, you've got to look to the outside and see what's happening out there. And Cousins just trying to get the ball out on time, doesn't see that Rollins is rolling up to the outside and was there to make a play. So Dom Capers dials up a nice coverage there on third and short.
Fourth down with Hyde waiting for it from inside the 25. A little room. Gets to the 40. And that's where Aaron Rodgers will have it with his team down 1. 2:22 left in the half. What if you died and then were brought back to life? This Wednesday, one man will find out. From the executive producer of The X-Files and 24 comes the intriguing new drama, Second Chance. Series premiere this Wednesday on Fox. Packers have scored on 2 straight drives. They started this game punt, safety, punt, punt. But it's turned around. Last 2 times they've had it. Starting at their 40. Jones, easy to spot. Ball is out. They're ruling him down. And we'll obviously get a number of looks at this.
Second down, Green Bay.
They said that Jones was down.
Well, really, the ruling here was forward progress. And since they ruled his forward progress was stopped and the ball did come out when he was being driven backwards, that's the right call.
And now here comes Baker.
The 2-minute warning.
Right at the 2-minute warning. And they will pick up the flag. Either way, that wasn't a fumble. Looked like the knee was down, but forward progress was stopped. And I guess John Gruden, or Jay Gruden rather, has thrown the challenge flag. He has. They also threw a penalty flag, but he's clearly down. And if they called forward progress,
to be corrected, like, the ball was being spot. The referee on the field ruled forward progress was stopped prior to down by contact. That play cannot be challenged. And this is the 2-minute warning.
That is correct. What he's saying is this is not a play that's reviewable, and you are not charged with a timeout for trying to challenge that, because it's one of those situations that is not reviewable.
2 minutes left in the first half. Get official NFL and team apps, podcasts, games, and more at iTunes.com/NFL. Even had Jay Gruden been able to challenge, he would have lost the challenge. James Jones' knee was clearly down before the ball came out. But they ruled forward progress on the field. It's second down and 5. Ball control starting to even out. Here's that play. See Goldson, he got a lot of the helmet. Almost ripped it off the head of James Jones, and Jones was clearly down before the ball came out. From the 45, Rodgers trying to set up a screen. Good catch by Starks. And Starks has got a first down. What a grab that was, with bodies all around him. Gain of 6 and a first down.
Well, they run the screen pass to James Starks. They've had a lot of big plays over the year with that to him. One of the things this offensive line does a good job of executing.
Pass is behind but caught by Richard Rodgers. On first down, a gain of 6. You can see the shot that Aaron Rodgers took after he dropped off that screen to Starks. Quick throw. Richard Rodgers got another first down. Inside the 40 now with a minute 13 and counting left in this first half. Incomplete. Under a minute to go, second and 10. Washington will get the ball to start the second half, but this has been some turnaround here after the Redskins really dominated the opening quarter.
Yeah, they did. They were moving the ball really well. Green Bay was struggling, but here the last few possessions, Packers have done a nice job climbing their way back into this ball game. They do something here, they could be taking the lead going in at half.
On second and 10, pass is caught by Jones with Breland all over him. A catch good for 8.
Yeah, I'm not sure how James Jones caught that one. Chris Baker was in the backfield on the ground. Breland was all over him. James Jones has been the go-to guy here in this first half for the Packers and Aaron Rodgers.
This is a big injury for Baker, not only because he's been playing great, but it stops the clock. Green Bay Packers do not have any timeouts left. But this injury by Baker stops the game clock at 45 before a third down and 2.
Now you talk about the year that he's had, Joe. He really has had a nice season. They brought in Terrence Knighton to number 98 there to shore up the nose tackle position, but Baker has been really good for a down lineman, getting pressure on the quarterback, and goes down right in the middle of the screen there. Hard to tell exactly what it is, but they're still tending to him.
It will cost Washington a timeout. They're left with 2. Baker able to get up and make his way off the field. He grew up as childhood best friends with Terrence Knighton. They grew up together in Windsor, Connecticut. Vowed someday they would be teammates in the NFL, and here they are. Baker's been here since 2011, and Terrence Knighton, they call him Pot Roast, an unrestricted free agent picked up from the Denver Broncos. And there they are together. And how about the vow they made to each other coming true here in 2015-16?
Yeah, and this offseason, Chris Baker got married, and who was his best man?
Pot Roast.
Terrence Knighton.
Third down and two.
That's pretty cool to go back that far and have those kinds of dreams and then to see it happen and then to be doing it here today in a playoff game together. That's pretty nice.
The Packers have not converted on third down in this game for a first down. Adams, he's got it. And in a year filled with drops for Devontae Adams, this is a big catch with Quentin Dunbar right there.
Yeah, they run a double move, a slant and go, and a lot of hand checking going on down the field. And those are the types of plays that they need Devontae Adams to make. Even that one wasn't caught real clean. As you said, he has had some drops, but what they liked about him coming out was his ability to go up and high point the ball down the field, and it just hasn't happened for him this year, especially coming off his injury. But a nice play right there.
And got out of bounds to stop the clock at 38 seconds. That was good for 20. Rodgers. Incomplete for Cobb. Coming up, it's the Visa Halftime Report. Kurt Terry, Howie, and Michael be along with scores and highlights. They'll talk about our first half here and the wild ending in that NFC wildcard game in Minneapolis, a game that ended on a 27-yarder miss that would have won it for the Vikings. Second and goal here. Just got it away. Adams wide open for the touchdown. And there is life with this Green Bay Packers offense.
They get Devontae Adams to the corner, but credit Aaron Rodgers for moving defenders that allowed him the room then to get it. You can see right here Dunbar, the corner. And as Rodgers looks to the left, as always going to the flat, it allows then the throw to Devontae Adams going to the back pylon. A nice release off the line of scrimmage. It's a good finish to that drive for the Packers.
Crosby knocks it through, and the Packers have scored 17 unanswered points and lead by six. Devontae Adams helped get him down there and then was left alone in the back corner of the end zone and hauled it in for the touchdown. He had only one touchdown all season long.
Yeah, you know, he got hurt early in the season, and as I said, it was a real struggle. Missed a lot of time, ankle sprain, and never was really the same. He's a little behind the eight ball then when he came back, and it just hasn't happened, not just for him, but you know, this season would look a little bit different if he had been able to emerge as they had hoped when the year began once they lost Jordy Nelson. But maybe this time of year is when he shines. I mean, he came off of that huge game last January against the Cowboys, which is really what gave everybody so much optimism about him as he came into his sophomore year.
When you talk to Aaron Rodgers about Devontae Adams, he said, realize he just turned 23. He's a young guy. He's still figuring it out, and he made that nice catch with Dunbar on him for 20 yards to set up Aaron Rodgers, and Rodgers has looked so much better here in the second quarter as his Packers lead by six.
And what we do know about Rodgers is if you, and really any quarterback, but especially him, you start making some plays, he's going to start feeding you the ball a little bit more, knowing that you're going to go up and be able to make the catch for him, and look for some more of that in the second half.
Washington will get it here again. They start the second half with the football. Out to the 20 is Ross. Remember earlier in this game, DeSean Jackson coasting for the end zone, saying on the bench, my fault, cruising, and he didn't get it in. The Redskins did not get the touchdown. Well, the Green Bay Packers just did on that flip to Devontae Adams, and the lead is 6.
Yeah, that one's going to haunt DeSean Jackson. I'm sure it's been on his mind this entire half after that play, and what a difference that would have made in what obviously was a pretty easy touchdown for him had he just gone after it.
Crowd doesn't like this, at least some in the crowd don't, but working into the wind with 24 seconds left, the Washington Redskins will head to the locker room down by 6. Led 11-0, but 17 straight by the Green Bay Packers, and the number 5 seed, led by number 12, able to celebrate finally. The lead is 6. Piece of halftime coming up after this from your local Fox station. Today's excitement brought to you by Nissan. Today's excitement brought to you by Nissan. It's a 6-point game here at the half, 17 unanswered by Green Bay. We welcome you inside our broadcast booth. I'm Joe Buck along with Troy Aikman and Mike Pereira. We'll hear from Mike in a second, but that was quite a turnaround in that first half for Green Bay.
Yeah, big turnaround once they had the wind at their back, and I think that's important going into the second half. Washington has the wind at their back to start the third quarter. They have to take advantage of that.
Meanwhile, Mike, let's go back to that last touchdown for the Green Bay Packers when they took the lead.
Yeah, I'll tell you, the Packers caught a big break here because although they were set initially, they ran an audible and then they did not get reset. So really, since it was a stop clock, that should have been an illegal shift and a 5-yard penalty against the Packers.
Instead, it was a touchdown pass to Devontae Adams, who made 2 grabs on that lead-taking drive. Went from 11 to 10 to 17 to 11, and that's where we are as Washington will get it to start this second half. You look at the first half stats, realize Green Bay the last 2 seasons when leading at the half, including the postseason, 19-1. Here is Ross on the return. Far side of the field, good return by Ross out across the 25. He gets hit out of bounds, but no flag as Dimitri Goodson got his pad into him, and we'll take another look at it. There's Goodson. No flag. Let's go down to Chris Myers.
Jake Gruden said he thought Chris Baker would be able to come back and play on defense, and he told his team, look, you're playing Aaron Rodgers defensively. You're in position to make plays. You need to step up and make plays. And he said at the half, man-to-man, we're as good as this team. He felt the momentum shift, and he did say he's ironing out some protection issues for Kirk Cousins so he could be more comfortable when he's throwing. And he did say the wind is not an excuse, but the wind is definitely a factor in this game.
So working with the wind at his back is Kirk Cousins. Gonna put it up. He's got Garcon out near midfield, went backward, and he's knocked down at the 48 by Demaryius Randall. And a nice start to this second half, 21 yards from Cousins.
An outstanding route by Garcon. Demaryius Randall has help over the top, so he's able to play underneath the route, but just because of the way Garcon sells it up the field, he gets Randall completely turned around. And a nice way to start this second half for Kirk Cousins.
Zahan! Why did he? What's up?
Here's Morris. Big run, Alfred Morris down inside the 35. Burnett on the stop after a gain of 19.
Brandon Sheriff, the rookie right guard, does a great job of combo blocking up to the linebacker level, which allows Alfred Morris then to get to the secondary. It's just good work by him in combo with the right tackle and then moving up and blocking Jake Ryan.
19-yard carry for Alfred Morris.
Yep, it's a hot. What did he? What's up?
Now Pierre Thomas in the backfield. Long time New Orleans. Same the plays made by Ryan. And a loss on the play of four as we go down to the field with Aaron Andrews.
Well, Mike McCarthy told me coming out of the half, the biggest thing for this defense that he wants them to concentrate on is not giving up these big plays. Guys, I will give you an injury update. Quentin Rollins, cornerback, he is questionable with a calf injury. He's sitting over on the bench right now in a lot of pain. Mike McCarthy actually walked up to me and said Ladarius Gunter is going to be in for him most of the time. 17 unanswered points for this offense. He said the biggest thing is they got some things fixed up on that line.
Well, no doubt about that. Now second down and 14. As rookie replaces rookie, Gunter in for Rollins. Cousins well protected, pass caught. That's Thompson. He's to the 30. Whistles. Ball came out. Play was dead after a gain of 7. So third down and 7.
Well, right now you've got the Redskins on third and long, and you heard the report that Jay Gruden acknowledges the wind certainly is a factor. And with these young defensive backs for Green Bay, if they're able to give Kirk Cousins some time, he's got some weapons where he can take advantage of the wind at his back down the field.
On third down, Cousins fires, passes, caught. That's Crowder. And he's going to be just short of a first down. It's fourth down and a decision for Jay Gruden. Good solid tackle after the catch by Hayward.
Yeah, Hayward comes up, makes a key stop, and now Jay Gruden is making the decision. He's going to go for it here on fourth down. I like the call.
To keep talking about the wind, but you get the wind at your back, you got to take advantage of all these opportunities. Here's a fourth and one as they pass on a 42-yard field goal.
What did he? What's that?
Cousins keeps it, floats it, got his man, big hit, pass caught, Jordan Reed down near the 6. And a little exhale from Kirk Cousins after that completion.
Yeah, it sure was. And good call here by offensive coordinator Sean McVay. They get Cousins out on the edge. And in behind all that is Jordan Reed. He gets lost as they're playing the run action. A big fourth down conversion.
17 yards on fourth and one.
What did he? What's that?
Cousins. End zone. Incomplete for Garcon. And Garcon is calling for somebody to replace him out there as Pierre's going to head to the sideline on second and goal. Jackson comes in along with Rashad Ross, first year player out of Arizona State, as Garcon is winded coming off.
Jordan Reed, he's down here at the bottom. That's their go-to guy in these types of situations.
Pass is caught. The hit by Hyde as Jamison Crowder takes it down to the 3. It's third and goal.
How about the year Jamison Crowder has had? He was really brought in initially to be a return guy and then compete for the wide receiver position, but he has really done a lot more on the offensive side than they had anticipated. He catches that ball knowing he's going to take a pretty good shot. He hangs on to the football.
Cousins starts in the shotgun. Punch formation down here at the bottom. Jordan Reed all alone up top.
Yeah, they're going to give him a little help with the safety.
Cousins for the touchdown. Spread them out and walk it in.
Yeah, nice design because they go safety help They want to try to give the help over the top here with the safeties to Reed. But now you've got Corey Lichtensteiger at center right here with the block on Micah Hyde. And that's the only block you got to make. And it's a walk-in for Kirk Cousins. It's an excellent job of play calling and execution by the center, who's making his first start in 11 weeks. Touchdown, Redskins.
Hopkins has already missed one in this game. High snap. This time he drills it. And the lead belongs to Washington. Kirk Cousins led this Redskins team in rushing touchdowns this year. That was number 6 on the season. And Washington back on top by 1.
Today's game on Fox is sponsored by Southwest. Transparency, low fares, nothing to hide. By Nissan, innovation that excites. By Burger King, get 5 delicious items for $4 only at Burger King. And by Microsoft Surface, the official tablet of the NFL.
Lincoln Memorial in D.C. and here in Landover, Maryland, the Redskins are back on top by 1. 9:41 left to go in the third quarter. Wind at his back. Hopkins will let it fly. The famous song for the home team as Cousins takes it in. Aaron Rodgers down by 1. Cobb in the backfield. Adams with 2 blockers out in front of him. Richard Rodgers and James Jones picks up 9.
Devontae Adams, who is on the ground. This could be a pretty good blow, a guy who's starting to get a little bit hot here in this game.
Grabbing his right leg. Packers have been trying to work Jared Abradaris into the lineup more, and he will check in now with Adams down. And they look at Devontae. We will take a break. The Packers have it. 2nd and 1 when we come back. Green Bay down by 1.
Today's game is sponsored by Verizon. Better matters.
2nd down and 1 for the Packers. Adams was able to get up and walk off the field. Abradaris in the lineup in the slot down here toward the bottom. Cobb in the backfield with John Kuhn. And John Kuhn will pick up the first down. Here, all the Green Bay Packer fans in attendance serenading John Kuhn as he looks at Devontae Adams on the sideline.
Yeah, and we'll see here what the Packers are able to do going into the wind. The play that Devontae Adams got hurt on, first down, picked up 9 yards, so staying manageable down and distance where they're not having to drive the ball into the wind on 3rd and longs.
Play action from Rodgers. Here's one down the field and incomplete for Jones. Again, there's Quentin Dunbar, the former rookie wide receiver. Only chance to make the team was to switch to the other side of the ball. And Joe Barry said, I look up and I think, man, we got Quentin Dunbar playing corner for us in the playoffs. He's been good.
He has been good. And I think you can say that about a lot of these guys. Scott McLuhan, the general manager this year, really did a fine job of finding players for this team.
Here's Abradaris, makes the catch. He will be knocked down a yard shy of a first down after he went around Will Blackman. 3rd down and 1.
You know, to follow up there on the wind situation, Joe, in the first quarter, now how much of it was just Aaron Rodgers kind of settling in, but just 1 of 8 in the first quarter. But then with the wind at his back, he was 14 of 20. And then, of course, we saw what Kirk Cousins did to open up this third quarter. And 3rd and short, if they can stay in these down and distances. But Green Bay this year, this was a tough down for them to convert.
319!
Pressure on Rodgers. Pass caught by John Kuhn for the first down. With Ryan Kerrigan bearing down on Aaron Rodgers, he was able to find John Kuhn for 6 yards.
And how about John Kuhn, a guy who picked up the first down moments ago on the handoff. Now they come to him on the pass. Rodgers has to get it out quick. Great adjustment by John Kuhn, being able to turn his body and make the play to convert the first down.
He talked to the team during the week, trying to rally his club to put the regular season and the way they finished it behind him. They lost their last two.
He was voted playoff captain by his teammates. It's a big deal.
On first down, Rodgers. Cobb, contact, no flag. Let's go down to the field and Aaron Andrews.
Green Bay Packers reporting Devontae Adams questionable to return with a knee injury. He was surrounded by a ton of trainers and doctors, as you can imagine. Now he's by himself. Looking very upset. He's told several players, I'm okay, guys.
Well, right now it's Aberderis, who they've been trying to work back into more of a prominent role for Aaron Rodgers, getting a look.
Well, this possession here, they've had Randall Cobb in the backfield throughout with John Kuhn at the fullback position.
Gets it on a toss. Sitting out in front of him. And a gain of 9.5 for Randall Cobb, brought down by D'Angelo Hall.
Well, D'Angelo Hall, he makes a good open field tackle, because if he doesn't make that tackle, Randall Cobb, he is off and running. And D'Angelo Hall, he's had an interesting year. He played a little bit of safety in some of their packages in previous seasons, but he came back from his injury this year. They moved him back there. He's been a real professional about it. He's got good cover skills, as we know. You got to be careful throwing the ball in his direction, but much more physical and a better tackler than you would anticipate for a guy who was once a cover corner.
They're down and one. It's John Kuhn again, and this time the Redskins stop him. Good penetration up front. It's fourth down and a decision for Mike McCarthy.
Yeah, I think Mike McCarthy's going to go for this. Just no movement there, and Preston Smith, he comes off the edge and he cleans it up. I think this is the right call too.
Ricky Jean Francois was in there for Washington. Now fourth and one, and they hurry it up. Play clock at 4. Timeout.
That was a good job by Aaron Rodgers calling the timeout. This is too important of a play to try to rush if you don't feel good about it and everybody settled in on exactly what you're going to do. Smart on his part calling the timeout.
Watch every NFL playoff game live on your phone with NFL Mobile. As Aaron Rodgers pleads his case that the play clock should have been reset.
Joe, it shouldn't have been reset. I'll tell you why. Because Green Bay did substitute, and then when Washington tried to substitute, they ran up to the line quickly, and that's when they're going to give Washington the opportunity to match up. And if the play clock's going to run out, they're not going to reset it.
So with the substitution, Washington gets a chance to answer, and here's a big fourth down.
See what Washington's able to do defensively. There's a lot of meat in the interior part of that defensive front. We'll see what McCarthy decides to do.
Hard count didn't work. Eddie Lacy does. Tripped up with a first down and a conversion for the guy with a bad rib. Will Blackman on the tackle, but a gain of 13.
Well, they get him behind their Pro Bowl player, left guard Josh Sitton. He leads the way and clears out the hole as he pulls around, and Eddie Lacy just gets in right behind him for an easy pickup.
5-1.
Lacy again. Lacy breaks loose. Goldson in his way. And Eddie Lacy down inside the five. A big conversion on fourth down, and now Eddie Lacy good for 30.
A lot of times you have check with Mays at the line as far as where you're going to go. Watch Aaron Rodgers. He gives a pat, lets him know what's going on up front. And the cutback lane that's created, John Kuhn makes a key block. Rodgers over there. It's been a long time since we've seen a cutback run like that with that much field for Eddie Lacy.
It's the longest run of the season for Eddie Lacy. Here's a toss to Starks running right. Touchdown, Green Bay. The Packers answer the touchdown by Kirk Cousins as Green Bay is back on top.
Well, they get in behind Brian Bulaga, and then you got John Kuhn, who also leads the way once again. He was in on this possession throughout. And just a nice drive answering going into the wind. They were able to keep it into manageable third downs. They go for it on fourth down, and it pays off with a touchdown.
The third lead change of the game. Starks takes it in. Just to make it a six-point game, and it is. And Eddie Lacy is the guy who got him down there. Converted on fourth down and ripped off a 30-yarder, and now James Starks takes it in. 44 and 27, getting it done for the Packers, up six. The divisional playoff round is next weekend on Saturday. It's Kansas City at New England on CBS at just after 4:30 Eastern. Then on NBC, it's the winner of this game at Arizona at night. We'll have the early game Seattle at Carolina, that we know. The other matchup will be Pittsburgh at Denver on CBS as well. Here is a kick return by Ross. And well covered downfield by the Green Bay Packers, who now lead by six. 10-yard return. Here comes Kirk Cousins. Back to the field, back to work. Kirk Cousins is in the middle of that huddle. First Redskins quarterback with a pass and rushing touchdown in a postseason game. Trying to become the first product of Michigan State to win an NFL postseason game since Earl Morrill did it back in 1972. His Dolphins beat Terry Bradshaw's Steelers in that perfect season. As Jordan Reed is overthrown. Second down and 10. Some notables. The history of this great franchise are here, whether it's Dexter Manley or Joe Theismann, Joe Gibbs, who won three Super Bowl championships with three different quarterbacks, Joe Jacoby, who is a Hall of Fame semifinalist and an honorary captain, a three-time Super Bowl champ. They are here in attendance watching their Redskins trail by six now. Under four to go, toss to Thomas. Here Thomas on second and 10 gets two.
It was good to see a lot of those former guys a part of this organization. Some really great history that comes with the Redskins. Had a chance to visit with Joe Theismann. As you see there, here Thomas almost puts that one on the ground, but you mentioned it. Congratulations to Joe Jacoby, one of the real great Hogs and a finalist. And I'm hopeful that he joins his teammate, Russ Grimm, in the Pro Football Hall of Fame.
Now third down and eight. For Kirk Cousins. Down the middle, and Grant stumbled. Looked like he was overthrown anyway, and it's three and out for the Washington Redskins after giving up that one-point lead.
Yeah, they had a shot. You know, Ryan Grant, he's running through it, and if Kirk Cousins, they're just not on the same page. You know, Ryan Grant's a young guy, and looked like Kirk Cousins was expecting him to continue up the field instead of across the field. But they had a chance had they been thinking alike.
Tress Way with the punt. Rouse the snap and then booms it. Micah Hyde stays away. And a good punt by Way down inside the 25. 49 yarder. Walter Payton NFL Man of the Year Award presented by Nationwide. A long history of honoring players. The three finalists will be announced during the AFC Championship game on January 24th. The winner being announced at the NFL Honors Award Show on February 6th on CBS. Shirzan nominee for the Packers, Sam Barrington, linebacker on IR. And for the Redskins, Ryan Kerrigan, who is right there with his team down six. After the Green Bay Packers, last time they had it, an 11-play, 80-yard drive. 56 of those yards on the ground running the ball. Took 5.5 minutes off the clock again as they work into the win.
Yeah, and they're sticking with what they went with in that last possession, Joe, with Randall Cobb back there in the tailback position. They were successful with him running the ball and then throwing out of those formations. They're staying with it here on this possession.
He gets it with John Kuhn in front of him, and Randall Cobb on first down picks up four.
You kind of see this offense just gain more and more confidence as the game has gone along. As you see what they did on their first seven drives in the last drive, and a big part of that, of course, was Eddie Lacy, who had not been able to get the running game going. He finishes that last one off, but Mike McCarthy, he likes what he's getting right now from Washington defensively against this look. They're going to stick with it.
Second and six, Cobb again, right side this time. Cobb is short of a first down after getting past Jason Hatcher. A gain of three. The Packers today, their first four drives produced 2 points for Washington on the safety. The last four drives, 24 points for Green Bay.
Tell you right now, you handed the ball to Randall Cobb running between the tackles. There's some big time hitting going on there, and he's absorbing it. A very tough guy, but that's why they haven't wanted to carry him carrying the ball most of the time over the year when he's lined up in that position.
That was D'Angelo Hall with that hit. Third down and three, quick throw, pass caught, James Jones, first down. Into the wind or not, Aaron Rodgers is getting hot, gain of seven.
See, once they split James Jones out, you got Dunbar. They're trying to communicate, and it's just pitch and catch then for the first down. And this second half, where Green Bay early in the game was facing a lot of third and longs, they've seen a lot of third and shorts, and as a result, they've been able to sustain these drives and convert.
Starks tripped up. Mason Foster comes out of there celebrating. Don't know if he tripped up Starks or if Starks tripped.
Yeah, Mason Foster, he goes low through John Kuhn and just gets enough right there. That's pretty good.
I thought maybe one of the offensive linemen tripped him up, but it was Foster with a good play.
Yeah, Mason Foster, another guy who has stepped in. He and Will Compton and Dunbar, so many guys have come in after this season began and made big time contributions to this team.
Second and 13. Open is Cobb, and he's got a catch in midfield with another first down. And that's how the third quarter will come to a close. A 16-yard completion from Rodgers to Cobb, and we've seen a smile on the face of Aaron Rodgers more today than we have in the last month.
Well, that ball comes out on time, and something, as I've said, you just don't see a lot of on the deeper throws, intermediate throws, and man coverage, and they created separation, and he puts it right on him.
Rashad Breland is down, so he gets attention. They don't have many corners left. So they pay attention to him on the field. The game clock will wind. The Green Bay Packers are sitting in midfield with a first down, a 6-point lead, and about to work with the win. which has been a factor in this game to this point. Things looking good for the road team. A little wink from number 12.
Well, this quarter is going to end, but expect Aaron Rodgers to come out and attack whoever replaces Breland at that corner position.
That's the end of quarter number 3. Aaron Rodgers and his Packers lead it by 6. Back after this from your local Fox station. Here's Breland, who looks like he's anxious to get back in there. Kerry Williams, who was just signed during the week, number 40, was released in year one of a 3-year deal he signed with Seattle. He's played in the Super Bowl, takes over for Washington. First down at midfield for Green Bay, leading by 6. Fourth quarter begins right here. Starks, a lot of room to run, and Starks has got a first down carry for the Pack.
The holes that this offensive line is beginning to open up is really impressive. You're going to see what James Starks has to operate with when he gets the ball, and there's just nobody there. Run blocking, they're really doing a good job here in the second half. Pass protection since J.C. Treader gave up that sack safety has been excellent. J.C. Treader has settled in too.
He's out at left tackle. They run away from that side, and Starks with another nice carry. On first down, Starks gets 7, knocked down by Goldson.
You know, we've just seen, really, I guess, some maturation, you could say, of this Packers offense as the season, or as the game has gone along. A lot of the same things we had seen for 2 months, and now this Packers team, ball's coming out on time, running the ball. There's holes, offensive line blocking them up. This is what we had seen for so many years. It's been missing.
And Aaron Rodgers has got his swagger back. They stay on the ground, and Starks has got another first down.
Well, that run right there, you. James Starks and the way that he finishes, and we've seen Eddie Lacy finish some of these runs, and Green Bay really didn't have much to show for in that first half, has got it going here in the second.
Knocking on the door of a 100-yard rushing day of the Packers, up by 6, first down. Against the Redskins. Rodgers gets another one.
Encroachment. Defense. Number 91. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
Second one on Kerrigan. Rashawn Breland coming back onto the field for Washington. They called Kerrigan. They could have called it against Chris Baker as well.
It's one of the things the Redskins worked exceptionally hard on this week, was hanging in there.
What a weapon that hard count is for Aaron Rodgers. First and 5. Starks cuts back. Good run. And James Starks is out of bounds inside the 5. Went around Preston Smith.
Well, Preston Smith, he's trying to pursue it from the backside, and when you do, then there's no contain. If you take the cutback angle as James Starks does, this Green Bay offense is rolling right now.
Eddie Lacy checks back in. He gets it. Touchdown. And you can forget the wind and all the talk about that. They just ran it right down the Washington Redskins' throat. And a 2-point try coming here for the Green Bay Packers. 4 for 6 on 2-point tries this season.
Well, we've seen, I've talked about it, that it doesn't take much. Once you have a play and You start getting a drive together, all of a sudden you start to recapture that confidence that you once had, and it can come on at any time. People have been waiting for it to happen for a while, and we've watched it occur here in the second half of this ball game. Throwing the football, protecting Aaron Rodgers, ball coming out, and then running the ball the way that you would expect with both Starks and Lacy.
This to make it a 14-point game. Pass is caught by Abradaris. And it is a 14-point Packer lead. Three straight touchdown drives. Five straight scoring drives for the Green Bay Packers, who say, hey, don't forget about us. We've got the reigning MVP on our side, leading by two touchdowns.
Today's game is sponsored by Nationwide. Nationwide is on your side. And by Intuit TurboTax, taxes done smarter.
These two organizations are linked because of the great Vince Lombardi in 1969. He became the head coach of the Washington Redskins. The Redskins finished that year with a record of 7-5-2, their first winning record in 14 years. But it was only 1 year here for the Washington Redskins. He passed away, Lombardi did, the following year. He is up in the Ring of Honor. Certainly is back at Lambeau Field for the Green Bay Packers. Spent the previous year as general manager for Green Bay after saying he had had enough of coaching, but then that changed. What did he say upon being hired by the Washington Redskins? Gentlemen, it's not true that I can walk across the Potomac, not even when it's frozen.
You know, when Vince Lombardi came here to Washington and he saw Sonny Jurgensen up close, he thought he was the best pure passer that he had ever seen, which says a lot. Said he reminded him a lot of Paul Hornung and his carefree personality. Of course, Sonny Jurgensen still doing the radio broadcast for the Redskins.
From the 20, now down by 14 points, they start with Morris. This defense for the Green Bay Packers really has played well, and you can almost go back to DeSean Jackson not taking it in for that early touchdown. Ha-ha, Clinton Dix forces him out. The Packers stand up defensively, don't let him in, and really made a statement. And offensively, Green Bay has taken over from that point.
They really have, and this Packers defense has tightened up too, and they've hung in there. And it's an important drive right here for this Redskins offense, the way that Green Bay has been able to move the ball themselves.
Four men on the rush. Pass is caught by Thompson. Chris Thompson knocked down a yard shy of a first down.
In the previous possession, you know, we did see Kirk Cousins take some shots down the field, and you know, that's something that this offense has been really good at this year, running the football. And they haven't run it great, but they stay committed to it enough to where you have to honor the play action passing, which allows some of these guys on the outside to create some matchup issues with DeSean Jackson and Jordan Reed, Pierre Garçon. And they need to convert here and then get something going.
What did he need? What's up?
On third down. First down, Morris. Nice run out across the 40. Clay Matthews came shooting through, but Morris ran away from him, a gain of 12.
Yeah, just some good tough running here by Alfred Morris as he was able to find the hole and then hit it. And a guy who came in as a rookie and rushed for 1,600 yards or so, and a 1,000-yard rusher in each of his first 3 years, and a lot of carries to go along with it. He's taken a lot of punishment and shared the load more this year.
Here's one for Reed. He finds a hole in this defense, and Jordan Reed is still going, but they're going to say he was down by contact inside the 40. 22 yards to Jordan Reed, and Demaryius Randall slow to get up.
Well, Jordan Reed, he's in the slot, and he gets a free release up the seam versus a safety in the middle of the field. That's pretty easy pitch and catch between him and
Kirk Cousins. You can see Reed comes down on the body of Demaryius Randall. You can see why he got up, continued to run. He is knocked down. But they marked the ball back just outside the 37. Take another look at Jordan Reed. Watch the right calf. Down by contact, maybe. Doesn't matter. It's not a reviewable play as he rolled on the body of Randall. It went for a 22-yard completion, first down, Washington. Matthews coming, and he gets home. Was not alone. Nick Perry there as well, and a huge sack for this Green Bay defense.
You see the speed of Clay Matthews. He starts in the middle, he loops all the way around, and Trent Williams, he picks it up late, tries to get enough on him, but not before Matthews is able to grab a hold of Kirk Cousins in the pocket. That's excellent job from where he started at to come all the way around and make a play.
A loss of 9, second and 19. Here's one for Jackson. It's broken up as two Packers came together. Demaryius Randall and Morgan Burnett. Randall slow to get up again, and that was an interception for either guy, and neither one of them comes away with it.
Yeah, that was an ill-advised throw by Kirk Cousins. He's trying to move the safety, Morgan Burnett, here, but he never moves on the play action pump. I mean, he tries to get him to go to the center of the field to open up that throwing lane. He doesn't bite, and Kirk tries to fit it in there anyway. Should have been an easy interception for either one of those two.
Randall now comes off the field. He and the other rookie corner, Quinn Rollins, have been banged up in this game. Now third down and 19. DeSean Jackson, two catches, 17 yards, and coasting for that touchdown early, didn't get it in. Not been a factor.
They bring in Dimitri Goodson, and he's down here across from Pierre Garçon.
Low snap. Underneath, Reed can't make a one-handed catch. And now, because of the distance on fourth and 19, the Redskins are going to have to punt it away.
Yeah, and that's just not a very good throw by Kirk Cousins. I mean, I don't know that they pick up the first down if he gives them a better ball, but they're going to be in field goal range. He's got room to catch it and get up the field before anybody would have been there. So that was an opportunity to at least try to come away with 3 points.
We'll be in a better position to go for it on fourth down. Pressure on that play by Mike Daniels. Good punt here by Way. As it checks up inside the 10, the Packers and Aaron Rodgers, who's been smiling today, back to work up 14.
Today's game is sponsored by Visa Checkout, the easier way to pay online. Sign up now.
2016 NFL Pro Bowl around the corner. Hall of Famers Michael Irvin and Jerry Rice select the teams of the Pro Bowl draft on Wednesday, January 27th. You can watch the Pro Bowl live from Aloha Stadium on Sunday, January 31st. Five-time Pro Bowler Sonny Jurgensen, Hall of Famer as well, went in 1983. Sonny Jurgensen watching, doing the radio. You can go to NFL.com/Pro Bowl to learn more. Up by 14, starting at their own 9. Off to Lacy, swallowed up in the backfield. Knighton was in there, a loss of 2.
Well, Joe Barry needs to come up with something to try to slow down this offense of the Packers, who have gotten really hot. This is a big possession in order to get the ball back to their offense, and it's a good start on first down with a loss of 2 yards. And you start to think that Joe Barry's gonna start dialing up a little more pressures if you see Green Bay begin to move the ball on this drive.
Second down and 12. Near near side, sideline. Jones out of his reach, flag throw. Quentin Dunbar in coverage.
Yeah, you see Jay Gruden. He's saying, hey, maybe it wasn't catchable, and that was my thoughts as well. There was some contact there, and I don't think that was a catchable ball.
Pass interference. Defense, number 47. Spot foul, automatic. First down.
I think Jay Gruden has a legitimate argument with that throw.
Instead, it takes the ball out to the 27. They show the replay on the board here. And here's another look. Mike Pereira, is that how you saw it?
No, I see it as catchable because when he went up in the air, the ball almost hit his fingertips, even though it landed outside of the white. I think that makes it catchable.
So the pass interference on Dunbar. First down, a carry by Lacy right side. Play made by Chris Baker. And then Lacy able to get a couple of yards as Baker brought Eddie down on his own body, and Eddie Lacy scooted ahead for two. Packers, for the first time all season, playing in their 17th game, have scored now on five straight possessions. Starks and Lacy a big part of that. Second and eight. Lacy out across the 30. Green Bay started the season 6-0, gone 4-6 since, with three home losses to NFC North rivals. They've lost their last two, trying to get a road playoff win to stamp their ticket for a date with the Cardinals in Arizona.
Well, the clock now becoming a real factor in this game for the Washington Redskins, and with that in mind, this is a critical third down for them in making a stop and giving the ball to the offense with still time down two scores.
Third down and six. Quick throw. Pass is caught. Abradaris. But he is short of a first down. It'll be fourth down. And the punt team will come on for the Green Bay Packers. Dunbar made the stop.
Yeah, so good job defensively by the Packers. And giving up the completion, but coming up and making a play and forcing the punt. We'll see what this offense is able to do for them.
Jamison Crowder waits for the punt from Maste. Crowder last in the league, the rookie, averaging just over 5 yards per return. Good punt. A fair catch called for, back inches inside the 10. Kirk Cousins, scoreboard, and the time on the clock working against him. Weekend is coming to a close here with this one in Landover, Maryland. All four road teams have never won on the same weekend. It would happen here as a playoff first if the Green Bay Packers win. Chiefs, Steelers, Seahawks all have stamped their ticket to another week of football. Quick throw to Garcon on first down, out of bounds to stop the clock with 5:50 remaining in the game. Down by 14.
Yeah, starting this possession off inside the 20-yard line. Not great field position. We'll see what they're able to do with it. But a guy who really hasn't gotten much action today is DeSean Jackson, but the one guy who can definitely chew up a lot of yardage.
Second and five. Cousins. Pass caught by Thompson for a first down. In the hurry up, it's something that Kirk Cousins studies, not just his own hurry up offense, but 2-minute and hurry up offenses around the NFL every week. Bad snap. Cousins corrals it. Incomplete. Stop the clock with 5:12 to go. Sean Jackson. He has been quiet here today, just two catches.
Well, he's certainly going to draw a lot of attention because there's not many people on this field that can run with him, especially with Sam Shields not playing once again here this afternoon for the Packers, but they've been unable to create some of the big plays. And then, of course, that mistake there, which Jackson took ownership on, was a four-point swing.
Second down, Cousins incomplete again. That's Jordan Reed, and he was well covered. He's seen a lot of Micah Hyde here this afternoon and evening from the Green Bay defense.
Yeah, Micah Hyde, who sees a lot of these tight ends, nothing quite like Jordan Reed. I know in watching him, he's as good as I've ever seen at the tight end position in terms of his route running ability. He's essentially a wide receiver. And I'd put his route running skills up against any wide receiver in this league as well. He's a pretty talented guy, and he's got the numbers this year to show for it.
Blitz. Washington picks it up. Third and 10. Pass is broken up. And a good play is made by the rookie Gunter as he knocked it away from Garcon. It's fourth down.
Boy, Kirk Cousins has a chance, but Gunter, he plays it really well. Nice route by Garcon. The ball just slightly thrown behind. If Cousins leads him, this is a completion and a conversion. But Gunter, he lays out and is able to get his hand on the ball, and that's good work against a veteran wide receiver.
He's playing in place of Quentin Rollins. They've got some good young corners on this roster. Well done by Ted Thompson.
And Jake Gruden, with 5 minutes to play, he doesn't have a choice but to go for it here on fourth down.
Fourth down and 10. Cousins is sacked. And the Packers take over. Nick Perry. And Aaron Rodgers onto the field celebrating what has got to feel like a fantastic game for the road team. The Green Bay Packers really stepped up here today.
Well, they sure did. And Nick Perry, he beats the Pro Bowl left tackle Trent Williams on a critical down here to end this drive on fourth down. He gets around the edge and makes the play on Kirk Cousins. Excellent work. Well, the offense came along, and in the second half, this Packers defense is really stepped up, and they've done a nice job really throughout this season, a lot of weeks holding this team in games when the offense had been struggling.
Four sacks on Kirk Cousins in this one by the Green Bay Packers defense.
5-4.
Don Capers should be beaming with how his defense has responded. Here's Starks, tripped up by Goldson. Timeout is taken by Green Bay. The Big East is playing some of the best basketball in the nation with four teams in the top 20. And this week we've got a pair of doubleheaders on FS1 starting Tuesday. DePaul and Xavier, Providence, Creighton, Georgetown, and St. John's, Marquette, and Villanova. Coverage on both nights starts at 6:30 Eastern. Only on FS1. Each side now with two timeouts remaining. Said Green Bay. Timeout taken by Washington with under five to go in this one. Packers won three road games en route to a Super Bowl 45 win over Pittsburgh. As the number six seed back in the 2010 season, they're a number five seed, and they are 4 minutes and 54 seconds away from a trip to the desert. Here's Starks. It's a yard, maybe a yard and a half. And with that, timeout taken by Washington. They are down to one. It's a 14-point game. Welcome back inside the booth. I'm Joe Buck. That's Troy Aikman. Well, we didn't know what to expect. We've done a ton of Green Bay Packers games this year. This is as good as we've seen them since the early part of the 2015 season.
Yeah, it's been a long time. I mean, it's been a real long time since we've seen this offense really come together the way it did in the second half. And the early part of this game looked a lot like we've seen for the last 2 months. But you know, they end this game. We'll see what happens here over the next 4 minutes or whatever. But, you know, they'll leave this game with a great deal of confidence and feeling good about where they're at going into next week, assuming that they're able to finish this one off.
Well, if that does happen, we were there when the Green Bay Packers went out there and just got taken apart.
That's right.
In week 16 against Carson Palmer and the Arizona Cardinals. The defense was suffocating. Third down and nine, Starks. Timeout taken by Washington, their final one.
Yeah, with the Packers getting the ball and they're in field goal range, there's no way they're going to throw the football with a chance to go up three scores. And even third and long, just hand it off and take this clock down as much as you can and force some timeouts from the Redskins.
Aerial coverage provided by Nationwide. And down below, they were so excited about the prospects for this Washington team. They won their last four. Jay Gruden with a really good year. They've got a lot to be excited about here with Washington, with the playmakers. They've got their quarterback. They've got some young, dynamic players on defense. The arrow is pointed up for the Washington Redskins. 29-yard try here by Mason Crosby. 17-point game. People have talked so much about the relationship between Mike McCarthy, the head coach, and now play caller again, and Aaron Rodgers. A nice moment there captured by Rich Russo, our director. Richie Zients, our producer in the truck, and Aaron Rodgers and this Green Bay team on their way to a date with the Cardinals.
Yeah, it's been a long time since we've seen Aaron Rodgers react the way he did after some of these drives. You know, I mean, we've all been spoiled for quite some time with the level of play of him and this Packers offense. And I know this feels good. It feels good for Rodgers and the entire team. And, you know, to win a playoff game, the first one is always the hardest. And I think a lot of times then when you go into that next round, these teams that had the byes, a little more pressure on them because there's a little bit more of a relaxed state from the wild card teams that are advancing. But talk about the Redskins, Joe. I think for the first time in a long time, they've got some real direction within their front office. I think they know exactly where they're going, what they need. And I do believe they'll get Kirk Cousins wrapped up. And, yeah, they're going to be a team that's on the rise.
Packers started slow. Punt, safety, punt, punt. But they've scored on six of their last seven drives. And lead this by 17. Ross will bring it out. And he is hit by Chris Banjo. We mentioned the name RG3 earlier in the game. Let's go down to Chris Myers with more.
Yeah, Joe, I talked to Robert Griffin again, inactive for this game. He said he's healthy and he's in limbo. He's been very supportive throughout the year during Kirk Cousins' run. In fact, even consoling him during this game in some of the tough spots. And Griffin said, I'm a Redskin as long as they had me. They picked up his option. So by March, they'll have to decide whether they want to trade him, pay him, or release him. And the ownership and the coaching staff would have to be on the same page. But he's anxious to play and expects to be playing somewhere. Most likely not in Washington.
Chris, thanks. That will play out in the months to come. Here's a screen for Thompson. Blocking in front of him. Big play to start this drive, down by 17. With 4.5 to go. Spencer Long was out in front blocking, good for 38.
Yeah, well, that was pretty interesting. They got guys out in front. Defense is playing really soft and get a lot of yards as a result.
Here he is again out of the backfield. He's not a big guy, 5'8", 193, but he's got good hands and is probably best suited for that role right there, catching the ball out of the backfield, that one for 7.
I actually thought that he would be used a little bit more in this ball game early as a receiver out of the backfield.
Cousins has Garcon. He's out of bounds. Redskins are not going to go quietly, but a flag is down. as Matthews and Kirk Cousins are jawing at each other at the end of that play.
Roughing. Defense, number 95, half the distance to the goal.
They get Dayton Jones for that hit on Kirk Cousins.
I think it was a good call, too. I mean, they're protecting these guys, and then there's the route. So you've got the Packers who are playing soft coverage and just saying, hey, we'll let you complete some of the other knee things, but then you got to come and make a play. And just as importantly, you got to keep them in bounds and keep the clock running.
This is a three-score game, 35-17. End zone. Pass is nearly picked off by Hyde. Jordan Reed was the target, and Micah Hyde, who is earning his paycheck here today, checking Jordan Reed, was there and almost picked it.
Yeah, that's the route that they scored the touchdown on earlier in the game, the double move up the seam, and Hyde in perfect position. Of course, not having to defend as much field with him down in here inside the red zone. But Micah Hyde, he's the one who's drawn the assignment. Overall, he's been okay.
He had that one-handed brilliant interception against Minnesota last week. Second and 10. That one just left the hand of Kirk Cousins in time to Thompson. Third down coming up.
Cousins, he takes a blow right at the very end of this play. Another good catch there by Chris Thompson.
That's Nick Perry again. About a half step too late, now third down and 4.
Rodgers is telling Mike McCarthy to challenge the play.
It certainly looked like it was Aaron Rodgers who came down and whispered into the ear of Mike McCarthy as he's going to challenge the catch. Green Bay challenging a ruling on the field, which is a completed catch. We'll get the call when we come back. We'll get the call here from Gene Steratore. Packers challenge on the catch by Thompson. One more look at it.
After review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. There was a completed catch. Receiver had possession, both feet down. Green Bay will be charged with its second timeout of the half and will have one timeout remaining.
Well, I guess that's the last time McCarthy will listen to Aaron Rodgers, at least on challenges. He may listen to him on some other things, but look at Aaron. He knows that, well, that one's on me.
Third down at 4. 17-point game. Jordan Reed took off. He's saying it was on the defense.
False start. Offense number 86. 5-yard penalty. Still third down.
That'll back Washington up 5 yards, third down and 9. Here is Aaron Rodgers coming down to, we think, tell Mike McCarthy to challenge that catch by Thompson.
It was almost simultaneous with McCarthy pulling the flag out of his pocket.
Here's a pass caught by Reed, but he is tackled immediately. Thomas was there for Green Bay along with Julius Peppers, a gain of 6. It's fourth down.
Yeah. Well, enjoy being home next week.
So you're saying Mike McCarthy and Aaron Rodgers were on the same page?
I mean, things were looking so good there, too, here in the second half between those two.
Their relationship has been dissected every which way. Fourth down and 3. Cousins got to get rid of it. And can't. Green Bay will take over. And it's Mike Neal who makes the play for the Packers defense.
Oh, That's just an excellent job by the defense of creating some pressure, getting after Kirk Cousins. You see the coverage on the back end of this play, and really played well. It was a team effort by this Packers group, and it's hard to win in the playoffs. It's especially hard to win on the road, even though we've seen the three other teams this weekend come away with wins. This is a big game for this Green Bay Packers team.
How about a 5-sack game for the Green Bay Packers defense? And Dom Capers, whose goal that he preaches to his group is to hold the opposition to 17 points or less. This is 18, but man, he will take it. What a job by Green Bay. You know, when you talk to Mike McCarthy early, when this offense wasn't clicking, talked about inconsistencies, and it never seemed to be the same part of the offense. It all came together here from the second quarter on first down. Here's Lacy. Compton's in on the stop tonight. Coming up next on Fox, The Simpsons and Cooper Barrett's Guide to Surviving, Family Guy, and Border Town.
Well, you talked about it a little bit ago, Joe, the rematch, if you will, from just a few weeks ago there in the desert. It was not pretty for this Green Bay Packer team, and that's about as good as the Cardinals have been all season long. That's about as good as it got for them. They were outstanding in every area of that ball game, and there's a look. 9 sacks, 8 of those were on Aaron Rodgers, and he took an absolute beating. In that game, you wonder if left tackle David Bakhtiari will be healthy enough to come back and return for that one.
It's a good topic to talk about when we come back. 2-minute warning here in Landover, Maryland. Some emotion from Aaron Rodgers. They're on their way to a divisional round game. There's first-year general manager Scott McLuhan, a real good football man who deserves a lot of the credit for building the foundation out with the 49ers when they kept going to the NFC Championship game, got to that Super Bowl, a loss under Jim Harbaugh to the Baltimore Ravens. Second down and 7 here, Lacy right side. And Lacy refusing to go down. How about that carry by Eddie Lacy? The ball came out. Washington saying that they got it, but Gene Steratore says it belongs to Green Bay. And that ball did come out. Looks like Breland is there to recover, but they don't see it. It would be, if this goes for a replay, it would be called for from above.
I've got to believe that. Well, maybe not. I was going to say, I got to believe they're going to review it.
They are.
Prior to the snap, the previous play is going to be reviewed.
So they were able to buzz down. That ball was out, and it looked clearly like Breland got on top of it. Meanwhile, next week, the game will be out on Sunday, is Carolina hosting Seattle, week 6. Cam Newton throwing for 162 yards in the fourth quarter. Greg Olsen, the game-winning touchdown with 32 seconds left as the foundation was being built for the Carolina Panthers with that undefeated season that lasted until week 16. It was a final of 27-23. Carolina game in Seattle, and here is another look at what we think will be a fumble. A turnover by Eddie Lacy. It would be the first turnover by the Packers in this game as it's in the arms of Bashaud Breland.
Well, I can tell you, Mike McCarthy, as good as this game has been for the Packers, he's not happy about this. This was an opportunity to just run out the clock with this first down, and you saw the look when we showed him and just shaking his head that now the defense will have to go out. They got to play, and then they score. There's onside kicks and everything that goes along with that, but you know, to go back to that Carolina team that you talk about, Joe, that game that you showed against Seattle when they won, that was the game that really, I think, legitimized them in everyone else's eyes. I think they already believed they were a pretty good team. But to do that against the defending NFC champions, I think it really gave them a great deal of confidence and gave everybody a look around the league as to what they were about.
Mike McCarthy will see the numbers for this offense and be thrilled with the way his offensive line responded in this game.
After review, the ruling on the field has changed to a fumble recovered by the Washington Redskins on the 32-yard line. It will be Washington's ball, first and 10 on the 32-yard line. Please reset the game clock to 1 minute, 51 seconds.
Here are the numbers of Green Bay Packers, 142 rush yards, one sack allowed, none over Aaron Rodgers' last 32 dropbacks. And with J.C. Treader out at left tackle, did this group step up on the road against a Washington defense that had really been pressuring the quarterback over the last month of the season?
17 sacks the last four games for the Redskins defensively, and Aaron Rodgers have been sacked 13 times in just the last two. So
incomplete from Cousins.
Really a great job by that offensive line.
And some goodbyes from RG3 to members of the field staff here in Landover.
I know this year has not been easy for him. When you're the second overall pick and you have the rookie year that he had, and you're the guy and you're the Heisman Trophy winner and all that comes with that, and was regarded as the savior of this franchise, to then only be active for one game all year. Having said that, I think he handled it pretty well.
Here's Jordan Reed, able to hop out of bounds with a first down. You think about Mike Shanahan and the front office here with the Washington Redskins when they traded all those first round picks to St. Louis to have the right to draft RG3. They came right back in the fourth round and drafted Kirk Cousins, and that wasn't lost on Kirk Cousins. He knows that the Shanahans believed in him. Now Jay Gruden believes in him, the free agent to be. He'll make his money, but this is a dedicated young man to the craft of playing quarterback in the NFL. Here's a pass caught by Ross. Going backward and can only get to the 15.
I think you bring up a good point, Joe, that what he had to say right from the very beginning of the meeting. I said, this has been quite a ride for you, you know, to go in the fourth round after they'd already taken RG3 and all that's come with that over the last few years. He immediately talked about what Mike Shanahan and Kyle Shanahan meant to him while they were here in Washington. So he's very appreciative of the opportunity.
Second and 8. Pass is batted into the air. Two guys had a shot at it. Thomas and Burnett. Incomplete third and 8. Jordan Reed comes up with the first 100-yard receiving game in postseason history by the Redskins. Team history, the only tight end to have a 100-plus yard receiving day is that man. Sky's the limit for Jordan Reed if he can stay healthy. Third and 8. Into the waiting arms of Nick Perry goes Kirk Cousins. Daniels there as well. It's fourth down. It's our game next week on Fox. Coverage starts at 11 a.m. Eastern. Seattle Seahawks, the number 6 seed, taking on the number 1 seeded Carolina Panthers. Fourth and 17. Long way to go for Thompson. He won't get there. This was a game Washington led 11-0. And the Green Bay Packers took over. First points of the game, a sack for a safety, Preston Smith, the rookie. Frustration early, but then Devontae Adams with two catches on that drive, including the touchdown. Kirk Cousins ran it in for a short-lived one-point lead. And James Starks was there to answer for the Green Bay Packers. Eddie Lacy plowed it in as well, and the ground game took over in this second half behind a new look offensive line for head coach Mike McCarthy.
Yeah, Washington came out to start the second half and came away with a touchdown and took an 18-17 lead, and then after that it was all Green Bay Packers with 18 unanswered points. And this is going to be a good week for the Green Bay Packers, finally kind of pulling it together and getting a chance to move on. And who knows, maybe this is like the magical year they had in 2010.
Well, Mike McCarthy has talked about how frustrated he's been having to talk about what was a 10-win season. Seeming discord between quarterback and head coach and play caller, but it all came together today. Redskins out, Green Bay Packers moving on with a convincing win. Back after this.